This is Dr. S. Prakash, Professor in D from School of Mechanical Engineering, Satyabhama University. We discuss about the rapid prototyping, a new technology era. First of all, see, what is rapid prototyping? Why we need rapid prototyping? How it differs from the conventional prototyping? What is the meaning of the rapid prototyping? It is nothing but a part which is made by a addition or subtraction or by sculpture method. It is done by using a specialized software called 3D software, which in turns cut into very thin sections or cross sections. And this is can fed into the machine called RP machine, which generates parts by layer until the solid replica of CAD model is penetrated or generated. This advantage of this process is very clear. The development of physical models can be accomplished significantly less than the compared to the conventional machining process. The next question arises, why we need a rapid prototyping? If you take a conventional machining process, it needs much more time from the generating of 2D diagram to the end product. Whereas here, it can directly get the real product within a few hours. The conventional method, the machining is a subtractive process which removes material for a long period of time in order to remove the stock. Whereas in machinist can carefully do the work to drill the given geometry or achieved. The small part of the complex can be machined. And why it is required? We go for a visualization, design iteration, a free form, a cost and time, a process planning, first to market when compared with other customers, critical for the today's industrial scenario. And a JIT concept, nothing but a just-in-time concept, can be employed here, where the industries are avoided high level of inventories. The day one and the day out. That means the day one production and the day out consumed. This is called as just-in-time. And go for the rapid tooling. That means no tooling are required or additional requires. This is the very fast technology used in our current scenario. And the year of inception, where it starts, in the year of 1986, the first commercial laser was launched. And move on to the later stage, we are launching the first commercial robot, which in the come to the life. And we move on to the third stage in 1963, the first interactive graphic system. And these are the base for the development of RP technology, which is launched in the year of 1988, which is called the first commercial RP prototyping system into the market. If you go to the classification of this technology, how the technology is classified. I already told you, we have three different classifications. One is subtractive process, which is called as material removal process. Another one is additive process, where we build the material to get the required component. Then it's a formative, you have to remove by sculpture method. These are the three important technologies which can give the overall view of the classifications. And these technologies are collectively called as desktop manufacturing, or rapid prototyping, or toolless manufacturing, or 3D printing, or freeform fabrication. If you take how it works, this system, how it works, building the required prototype by various methodology. First one is the design of a part. From the 3D basic model to the required CAD files. And this can be done by a separate software called .stl software or IGS format, which is called nothing but standard triangulated language file or interface graphic change file. And this can be fed into the RP machine to build the required prototype. So these are samples how the CAD model is created, how you get the near net shape, and how you get the final shape. Now how do you create a 3D model using the latest software? First we can see the diagram. 2D conversion, the 2D drawings are converted into required 3D models using a standard software called SolidWorks or some other Creo softwares. Then these software files are converted to the design files, which in turn is converted to the machine accept files called file conversion. Once the files are converted, it can be transferred into the RP machine for the getting product. These are the some solid models available. Let us discuss the AutoCAD, one of the versatile software, and SolidWorks is another versatile software, and we have a Tinkercad. These are the different solid models which can convert the 2D diagram into 3D models, which in turns converted into required file format. Apart from this, we have few more mesh models as well as parametric modelers. And these are process steps, how the 2D drawings are converted into RP machines, which is fed into the RP machine, how the prototype is obtained. The 3D printing is an additive manufacturing process that creates three-dimensional object from digital dimensional informations. And these informations are sliced into layer by layer to the required cross section, then it printed on a top of the other, one over the other. There are the 3D printers, flat and subtractive process like CNC, or we can call it as milling. And these are usually considered as a separate group other than the machining. And these are the parts made by the printing technology, a few parts. First one is the blade, we can see the blade. Second one is a dental Third one is the how the strategies are going on, creation of a solid model into a machine model, then go to the final prototype. These are the samples made by the RP technology. This is another one, how the parts are made by using standard software. One is a wireframe model, how the car is drawn with a 3D printer. A wireframe model is converted into 3D prototype. So this is useful for whenever the customer wants, what are the changes to be done before going to the final productions, they can be done in the initial stage itself. And these are another samples available for showing the 3D printing parts. One is a toy model, another is a bicycle. The designs are rectified, the design set itself, before going to the commercial productions. When the customer wants to change the dimensional aspects or wants to change the design features, this can be done easily in the RP machine. And this is another one new technology called 3D ink printing technology, where the various models are used, 3D printing, ballistic manufacturing, model maker and multi-jet modeling. And all these are, the printing can be done by very easily with help of standard softwares and standard machines. This is the concept of 3D inkjet printing technology. It refers to the entire class of machines that employ the inkjet technology. The first was 3D printing, developed by MIT in USA, and later moved to the Z corporations, where they manufactured this type of printing machines for sophisticated environment. In this, the machines, the parts are built on a platform situated in the bin full of powder material. An inkjet head was employed there, which deposits the filament into a solid model which can be printed as and required by the customer. The platform is lowered whenever they want to higher and lower. When the finished part, the green part is removed from the unbound powder and can be blown off. This the finished part can be also filtered with wax or glue or other sealants to improve the durability as well as surface finish. The typical layer thickness in order we can achieve by 0.1 mm. This process is very fast and produce parts with shiny and grainy surfaces. Manufacturers can be used to different materials such as starch-based powder as well as ceramic powder. Machines with 4 color printing capable available, and these are the file formats which it requires generally for conversion of 2D drawing into 3D drawing, in turn which converted into the RP machine. One is .stl or OBJ format, another one is mainfold, which can be, there is no holes at all, and which cannot have the overhangs, loose faces, inverted normals and intersecting geometries. This is a machine which you can see, a 3D printing machines. The diagram shows the basic model of 3D printing machines. It consists of a required components, a platform, a support, as well as a head which can print the given models. Once the model is sliced, that is sent to the 3D printer, where you have a print icon, we can click it. The required geometry is printed immediately. The printer can move all three directions, especially X, Y, Z, which converts X left to right and Y is back to forth and Z is up and down. This is called as a FDM printer. This is a replica, this is a 3D printing machine having the different views, the front portion, the front view as well as side view and as a front view. Let us go the advantages of the 3D printing machines. Reduced cost, reduced product development time as well as the cost. If you go for the generally conventional machines, start from the drawing to the end product, it takes much more time. For creation of drawing, we need a standard software, as well as for creation of models, we need a patterns. These patterns are made and where the patterns are converted into real 3D products. That product takes much more time from generation of drawings to the end product. We have to use this type of technology, we can get it immediately within an hour or within a day. Apart from this, it gets a good product to market sooner. It gets the products to market sooner. We have launched the product with again the customer's computer in advance. And enhanced communication between marketing, engineering, manufacturing and purchasing. The customer can able to view the models and represent the queries, which in their turns easily rectified. Then present physical model at the critical design reviews. Whenever the design iterations are required, we can use this technology for getting the repeat prototype. And generate precise production tooling is another area where we find the major advantage of this RP technology. And it is usually mainly used in modeling, product design, reverse engineering, short production runs and tooling, in jewelry designs, as well as in medical application, especially in surgical planning for implant and prosthetic designs. And these are the various applications of RP technology. This is a flowchart which represents the RP family, where it starts, where it ends. It starts from the iteration process, generative process, finishing process and design, as well as all is used in different areas in aerospace, automobile, in jewelry, as well as in biomedical and consumer electronics, where and whereas in home appliances. And the benefits of this technology, you can see that visualization, verification and iteration and optimization for design engineers. In the area of design field, you can find these benefits of this RP technology. And rather than go for communication for a simultaneous engineering, Then you can go for the form and fits for components. They test samples for marketing studies of consumer designs or preference. It helps in production planning also. And metal product is fabricated from a polymer parts. And tooling can also fabricate from the polymer parts. These are the advantage benefits of the RP technology. So far we discussed about the basic fundamental RP technology. In near future class, we will discuss about the RP technology in advanced level, wherein we are used for the different applications in biomedical as well as engineering to discuss about the higher end of the machines for different applications. And thank you.